الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to the course Understand Quran and Salah the Easy Way. In lesson number 14, we will study Adhan and Wudu. Okay, and also study some more patterns of Nasara. Take other, some more verbs. Let us start the words of Adhan. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest. You know, Akbar basically means greater. You know, Kabir is great. Akbar, greater. Al-Akbar, the greatest. Saghir, smaller, small. Asghar, smaller. Al-Asghar, the smallest. Hasan, good. Ahsan, better. Al-Ahsan, the best. Should be Hasan. Hasan is better. Hasan is good. Ahsan, better. Al-Ahsan, the best. Allah is Akbar. Allah is greater. The sentence is incomplete. Akbaru min, greater than who? It is not answered. Why? Because Allah is the creator, the rest of us all are creatures. There is nothing that can be brought in front of Allah to compare. You cannot even imagine to compare creation with the creator. That's why there is no answer to it. And that's why the translation of Allahu Akbar is, Allah is the greatest. This is one interpretation. Allah is the greatest. Allahu Akbar. How do you bring this Allahu Akbar into our life? Take a dua out of it. Try to extract a dua out of this Allahu Akbar. What dua can you make? Well, you can say, Oh Allah, help me to make you greatest in my life. Oh Allah, help me to make you greatest in my life. Well, you will say, that's what I do. I will say, not necessarily. For example, if it is Fajr time and the Muadhin says, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, and I just turn around and sleep. Did I really make or accept greatness of Allah in my life? Not really. I have made my sleep greater than Allah's command. Suppose if there is my boss, he asks me to do something, and I don't do that, and I just say, boss, you are great. I'm sure he'll not like this. So, you know, we should follow Allah, not just say Allah is the greatest. Yes, we should say, but follow it in our life, in our customs, in our traditions, in our, you know, rituals of marriages and ceremonies. We follow so many other things out of fear of traditions. We should follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu, I bear witness. Ashhadu, af'alu, you already learned that. Af'alu, so ashhadu means I bear witness. Fa'ala, af'alu. Shahida, ashhadu, I bear witness. Af'alu, a'budu, a'udhu are all on that pattern. An means that. Remember, this is a very, very important word. An means that. An means that. La ilaha illallah, there is no God except Allah. You know this. What's the meaning of ashhadu, I bear witness that la ilaha illallah? That means, ashhadu means, I bear witness means, my talk and my actions at home or outside, in the office, in the market, with the friends, in all times, they bear witness, they show that I believe in Allah to be the creator, owner, cherisher, the ruler of the whole world. I obey him alone. I ask his help alone. I love him the most. And I obey his laws in all areas of my life. This is the meaning of ashhadu. Okay? Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Ashhadu, I bear witness. Okay? Anna means that. By the way, again, ashhadu is coming. So let me add one more thing here. Every day, five times a day in the Adhan, we are repeating Ashhadu, Ashhadu, Ashhadu. You know what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ. We have made you this middle nation so that you be witness for the whole mankind. That means, be witness means, you convey the message of Islam through your words, through your writings, and through your actions. And that's what we are repeating 5 times a day. Ashhadu, ashhadu, ashhadu. And in salah also while sitting, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So ashhadu has a lot of implications here. We should change our life, try to change our life to represent Islam in our talks and in our actions. This is a reminder call. Ashhadu anna. Anna means that. An means that. Anna means that. You know, together they come almost 900 times. So be careful. Ashhadu and just use these examples, frequently occurring examples. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. I bear witness that there is no God except Allah. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the messenger of Allah. So an means that. Anna means that. You know what is in? Let's not mix it with in. Don't mix in with an. In is if, inshallah, if Allah wills. In means if. And don't mix inna with anna. Inna means indeed. Inna Allah ma'as sabirin. Indeed Allah is with those who are patient. So we have 4 words, an, anna, in, inna. An means that. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Anna means that. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. In means if. Insha'Allah. Inna means indeed. Inna Allah ma'as sabirin. These 4 words come in the Quran 2,764 times. Very precious. Okay? So remember them. Remember the meanings with examples. Can you, all of you please, can you give me the example of an? An means that. Example. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Anna means that. Example, ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. In means if. Example,
inshallah.
Inna means indeed. Example,
inshallah.
Okay, you can repeat it and just memorize it thoroughly. So, an means that, anna means that, in means if, inna means indeed. Can you say it? An means that, anna means that, in means if. Inna means indeed. Again, an means that. Anna means that. In means indeed. In means if. Very good. Inna means indeed. So practice this and learn these 4 words thoroughly. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Rasul, the plural is Rusul. And they together have come hundreds of times in the Quran. Rasul and the plural is Rusul. What is the meaning of Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah? I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah. Meaning my talk and my actions in every place and every time show that I accept the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam without hesitation. And Quran and Sunnah are the criterion of right and wrong in my life. And I don't need any other proof to obey the messenger. My likes and dislikes are according to his sayings. And I love him more than any human being. That's the meaning of Ashhadu Anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Hayya ala, can you just translate once? Ashhadu, I bear witness, Anna,
that
Muhammadan,
Muhammad
Rasulullah,
is the messenger of Allah.
Ashhadu Anna Muhammad Rasulullah, I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. Hayya ala salah. Hayya means come. Hayya means come. Hayya means come. Ala salah. Salah means prayer. Plural of salah is salawat. Hayya ala salah. Come on salah in principle. But you know, each the preposition in a language is translated differently. Depends on the language you are translating. In Urdu we'll say aao namaz ki taraf. We will not say namaz par aao, come to salah. No. But anyway, hayya ala salah, come to the prayer. And I told you, I talked to you about this translation of prepositions in our previous lesson. Hayya, come ala al-falah, to the prosperity. Falah, prosperity. What is the meaning of that? If you come to salah, you will get prosperity in every sense of the word. Your faith will become strong. You will get true peace of mind and heart. Your intellect will grow because you will be interacting with Quran and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and dhikr. And your thoughts will be streamlined, your body will benefit, you will wake up in the morning at the right time, your social networking will become stronger, and you will get used to working on time. And most importantly, we will get true everlasting prosperity in the hereafter. This reminder is especially, you know, after Hayya ala Salah, Hayya ala Falah, especially, you know, we are reminded because many people do not come to Adhan because they are busy with their work. They think that this work, whatever they are doing, or the sleep that they are, you know, enjoying, they think that a little more sleep will give me more enjoyment or prosperity, or a little more work will give me more business or benefits. So that's why Allah is reminding, come to the prayer, and that's where you get the prosperity. And also, it is, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't say here, I mean, the Adhan, the system given by Allah, in this one, we are not, you know, told to pray. Sallu Salah, it is not Sallu Salah. Come to Salah, that means come to Masjid, establish Salah. Come to Masjid. Here is a message, Aqimu Salah, in other words. It doesn't say, you know, just pray in your homes. It says, come to prayer and come to the prosperity. So if a person does not come, he's like a crazy person who is running in the direction opposite to what he's looking for. That means opposite to the prosperity. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. It's a reminder at the end that Allah is the greatest. Allah is the greatest. La ilaha illallah. There is no God except Allah. That means if you come, that is better for you. And if you don't come, Allah is the greatest in His place. Nothing, Allah, there is no decrease in His greatness. If you don't come, He does not need you. There is no God except Allah. That is the eternal absolute truth. Okay? So if you don't come, it is your loss. That's a reminder, beautiful reminder. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. If you want to go and see more details about this Adhan, you can go to our website www.understandquran.com and you can check the Adhan workshop there. Not only we explain you the meanings of the Quran, but also give you training by our friend Qari Imran Khan, the training of how to give Adhan. Okay, just on the website, freely downloadable. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. There are two parts now, the recital before, or the dua before wudu and after wudu. Before wudu, we say Bismillah. And after wudu, we say Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu Allahumma ja'alni min at-tawabin wa ja'alni min al-mutatahirin. In this dua, many words are familiar to you. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. I bear witness that there is no God except Allah. You know that. Wahdahu la sharika lahu. Wahdahu means he is alone. La sharika, no partner. Sharik means partner. La sharik, no partner lahu to him. Wahdahu la sharika lahu, he is alone, there is no partner to him. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is his slave and his messenger. Abduhu means his slave. And rasuluhu, his messenger. Allahumma ja'alni min at-tawabin. Allahumma, O Allah. Allahumma is O Allah. Ij'alni, make me. If you mix Allahumma ja'alni, O Allah, make me. Min at-tawabin. Min is from. At-tawabin. Tawabin means those who repent often because we commit mistakes. So make me from those who repent often. Waj'alni, and make me. Wa ij'alni, and make me min al-mutatahirin, from those who purify themselves. All kinds of purity, of faith, of place, of manners, and so on. We'll take a break, brothers and sisters. We'll be back after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. Welcome to you after the break. Inshallah, in this part of 14th lesson, we will do grammar. Use TPI, total physical interaction, that is, you are hearing it, seeing it, thinking it. Please say it and show it, as we, you know, ask you to do. And do all of these with enthusiasm and love, because in the coming, you know, 10 minutes, we will learn a couple of words with practice, you know, which occur in the Quran hundreds of times. We have been telling you that fa'ala has six different styles in Arabic. Four of them are famous. are very common. And the difference is only in the sounds. You know, just one, you know, like oo or e or a, just changes in sounds, that's all. So far we have done fataha, the first pattern, fa pattern, that's what I have written there. Fataha yaftahu. And under this pattern, we learned two different verbs. Fataha ja'ala. Fa'ala also falls under the same category. So a total of three. The next pattern is nasara pattern. Nasara yansuru. The difference is, here you see fataha yaftahu. This is nasara yansuru. Instead of yansaru, it is yansuru. And the only thing is it is easy to pronounce yansuru than yansaru. And that's why Arabs have made it yansuru. That's a simple explanation. If this is yansuru, then that effect of u on third letter continues. Yansuru, yansurun, tansuru, tansurun, ansurun, ansuru, unsur, unsuru, la tansur, la tansuru. Up to this only. The rest is same as fa'il, like nasir, mansur, nasr. Fatih, maftuh, fatih. Ja'il, maj'ul, ja'al. So the rest is same. I also told you that this nasara pattern, bab nasara, occurs most frequently in Arabic language as well as in the Quran. So let us do three more verbs that occur in the Quran, like kafara 461 times, and dakhala 78 times, and abada 143 times. So a total of almost 600 or 700 occurrences that we will learn now, inshallah, in coming 5-6 minutes. So let us repeat after me. Kafara, he disbelieved.
Kafara, not disbelieved.
By the way, kafara has two meanings. Kafara means to disbelieve, and kafara means to be ungrateful, opposite of shakara. Shukr and kufr are opposite. That is one meaning, and the common meaning is to disbelieve, to reject, to deny. Okay? So please repeat after me with actions. Kafara, he disbelieved.
Kafara, not disbelieved.
Kafaru, they disbelieved.
Kafaru, they disbelieved.
Kafarta, you disbelieved.
Kafarta, you disbelieved.
Kafartum, you all disbelieved.
Kafartum, you all disbelieved.
Kafartu, I disbelieved.
Kafartu, I disbelieved.
Kafarna, we disbelieved.
Kafarna, I disbelieved.
You see, we are not making statement of our faith. Somebody was telling me, why are you making people practice kafartu, kafarna, I disbelieve, we disbelieve. This is not a statement of our faiths, it is practice. And second thing is, a Muslim has to be kafir also, as far as sense of the word is concerned. And a Muslim has to be, فَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِالطَّاغُوتِ وَيُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ. So we have to be kafir of ta'ghut and believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The word kafir by itself is not something humiliating or something negative. Kafir means to disbelieve in something. Okay. Similarly, ذَكَرَ. ذَكَرَ means he remembered. Khalaqa is almost 248 times. Dhakara is 163 times. He remembered. Dhikr is to remember. Okay? We are doing dhikr, remembering Allah, for example. So, dhakara, he remembered. Dhakaru, you they remembered. Dhakarta, you remembered. Dhakartum, you all remembered. Dhakartu. Same thing. Same thing. So, just, you know, if you are master at nasara, you can just replace nasara with dhakara. It's the same pattern. So, please repeat after me. Dhakara, dhakaru. Zakarta, zakartum,
zakarta, zakartum,
zakartu, zakarna,
zakartu, zakarna,
yadkuru, yadkuruna,
yadkuru, yadkuruna,
tadkuru, tadkuruna,
tadkuru, tadkuruna,
azkuru, nadkuru,
azkuru, nadkuru,
uzkur, uzkuru,
uzkur, uzkuru,
la tadkur, la tadkuru,
la tadkur, la tadkuru,
zakir, ذاكر مذكور مذكور ذكر ذكر هو ذكر هي ذكرت هو يذكر هي تذكر okay ذكرت like you know you can remember sister's name like نزهت فعلت نجهت فعلت ذكرت عورت فعلت like in Urdu we say عورت anyway ذكر comes 163 times we have رزق رزق means he gave he provided رزق is you know provision from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Risk is what is given. So, razaqa, razaqu, razaqa, he gave, they gave, you gave, I gave, we gave. So, the same thing. So, let us repeat razaqa just once, 122 times. Razaqa, razaqu,
razaqa, razaqu,
رزقت رزقتم
رزقت رزقتم
رزقت رزقنا
رزقت رزقنا
يرزق يرزقنا
يرزق يرزقنا
ترزق ترزقنا
ترزق ترزقنا
أرزق نرزق
أرزق نرزق
أرزق أرزق
أرزق أرزق
لا ترزق لا ترزق
لا ترزق لا ترزق
رازق
رازق
مرزوق
رزق
هو رزق هي رزقت she gave she provided هو يرزق هي ترزق she provides. So if you practice inshallah with this little time we cannot do more, but you practice it at home with your friends and inshallah you will be master at these things. And you just practice for 10 minutes and you will learn all these words which come in the Quran hundreds of times, mashallah. Now we come to learning tip, and in this one again I relate to you a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abdullah bin Busr reported, which is one of the Abdullah bin Busr reported, one of the companions said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, O Messenger of Allah, there are many injunctions of Islam for me, so tell me something to which I may hold on. So he said, keep your tongue wet with remembrance of Allah. Keep your tongue wet with the remembrance of Allah. لا يزال لسانك رطبا من ذكر الله. This is a very, very, very important instruction from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You see, somebody can say, I'm walking to the masjid, I'm earning halal, so it is also dhikr. But the Prophet didn't say, dhikr, do dhikr in your heart. He recommended that we should do dhikr with our tongue. Why? Because if you do it with tongue, the tongue will bring you back to remember. For example, you're walking on the street. You're doing dhikr of Allah, subhanAllah, 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 and a new car passes by. What happens is your brain and your eyes, yourself, you're attracted by the car and your brain is just gone with the car. You even forget you are doing dhikr. But if you keep doing it with your tongue, subhanAllah, subhanAllah, subhanAllah. Now as you're watching, the mind is gone, but the tongue is saying subhanAllah, subhanAllah, subhanAllah. And after a while you get reminded, I'm doing dhikr. So you come back. So by doing dhikr with tongue, it ensures, at least one benefit of it is it ensures that you come back to it again and again. That is one thing. Another thing, the interesting thing is, you may never have heard anybody telling you that, well, you know what, I was talking so much today that there is pain in my tongue. Tongue never pains, subhanAllah. So you can always continue dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the day of judgment, if you have empty slots of time, they will be empty. But just look at those slots filled with dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our assignments actually are two on recitation. Recite 5 minutes from the mushaf. So we said iqra'ul Quran, recite Quran, it will be intercessor on the day of judgment. And also recite 5 minutes from memory as you're walking, coming, going to the masjid, to market, house, masjid. So just keep reciting Quran as much as you can, at least 5 minutes, increase the habit, and inshallah you will learn a lot. And inshallah we'll learn more. With these 13 lessons we have learned 76 words which occur in the Quran 30,854 times. Inshallah we'll continue in the next lesson. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.